Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, with our main topic today. Under the auspices of President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, Egypt hosts on the 16th and the 17th of October 2019, of course, the Egypt Cannes Conference for Investment and Development, and it is chaired by the Migration Minister Nabila Makram. Well, Egypt Cannes is one of the very successful conferences that was held in Egypt since President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi came to office. This is the fifth edition that is going to take place in Cairo, and it would start on the 16th of October. The previous editions were really successful editions, and it was titled, for example, Egypt Cannes for Women, Egypt Cannes for Education, and Egypt Cannes for Science. To shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to host today Mr. Hani Sidarous, one of the participants in the fifth Egypt Cannes conference, and he is also owner of stores in Australia. Welcome, Mr. Sidarous.
Thank you.
Mr. Sidarous, is it the first time that you participate in the Egypt Cannes conference? This is the fifth edition.
This is the first time that I personally will be engaged in the Egypt Cannes conference.
Yes.
Was invited after some time in Australia running businesses to speak.
Yes.
And talk about the business experiences.
Yes. How did you get to know about this conference?
Well, through the Egyptian embassy, we have close ties in the Egyptian embassy in Australia.
And you were nominated, or you applied?
I was nominated.
Yes.
by the Egyptian embassy to as a business owner in Australia.
Yes.
And I was lucky enough to be invited.
Yes. So, what is the criteria by which you feel that they choose the participants in this conference?
The criteria was to be Egyptian or Egyptian heritage.
Yes.
And successful in business. And so I was lucky enough for them to tick both those boxes.
So we know that you are an Egyptian and you are living in Australia.
Yes.
You have you run your own business and your stores there.
That's correct.
How many years have you spent there?
I've been with the brand for probably close to 40 years, and I've been running my own business within the brand for about 15 years myself.
Yes.
We have recently run an award in the ACT where I come from as the largest employer of youth. So it was very exciting.
Yes, yes. So how do you feel now when you are participating in a conference held in Egypt, like Egypt Cannes, one of the very successful conferences held in Egypt?
Extremely excited to be here. I've been watching on the sidelines for a long time.
Yes.
And there's some excitement in the air. There's some excitement within Egypt.
Yeah.
Personally, I've been here this year three times, and
yes,
I haven't been for 7 years before that. So there's a lot of excitement, and I'm extremely happy to be here.
So this edition, the fifth edition of Egypt Cannes, is titled Development and Investment.
Yes.
So how do you see the importance of this title?
Oh, I think this is part of the vision, part of a plan that I suggest has been created many years ago, and this is the next stage in it. It's going to be a really good opportunity to have government leaders, private sector, business owners all in the same room talking about the future and
yes,
how we can work together.
So, Mr. Sidarous, what do you expect from this fifth edition of Egypt Cannes?
I expect to learn a lot of some of the opportunities that lie here, how we can help Egypt. I feel very passionate about helping Egypt. I was born in Egypt, so my children asked me, who are they? I said, well, you're Egyptian born children. So,
yes,
you know, I'm very excited to hear what's going to be shared amongst everybody in the conference.
Yes.
And learn.
Yeah. So, Mr. Sidarous, how can Egyptians abroad help in development in Egypt? I mean investors, Egyptian
yes,
investors.
Well, I think with all investment, people are attracted to invest when there is a return, and that's what it's all about, it's business.
Yes.
So if I don't think we'll be asking for guarantees from the government, but if the government put policies in place to ensure that there's support, people will invest. They won't be fearful to invest.
Yes.
They will invest, no problems.
So you've mentioned the very important thing, the guarantees or the insurance.
Not so much
of any. Yeah.
Sorry, go on.
Yeah.
Not so much guarantees, but just policies to yeah. protect if things do go wrong, because people will be very hesitant to invest if there's no measures to protect, to mitigate risk.
Yes. So in your point of view, what are the projects that the Egyptian market need?
Good question. So I've done a little bit of research, and I know that Egypt import almost three times what they export. So there's the answer right there. I mean, $40 billion is, don't quote me on the numbers, but roughly $40 billion is spent yes. on items coming into the country. Now, not all of it can be sourced within the country, but if 10% was sourced, that's a $4 billion business
yes.
straight away.
Yes.
So I think we need to deep dive into what's coming into the country and look at what the opportunities are.
Mm.
Personally, I see opportunities in farming, specifically around beef and quality beef, opportunities in recycling. I think there's big opportunities there. And so we'll have a look, we'll listen on what's available.
Yes, yes. So how can the economic reform help in attracting new investors? Of course, after policies and insurances.
How can we attract more? I just think if I come back to the original comment around government putting policies in place and understanding that if we walk together, we'll win together, rather than, you know, people will be concerned about investing if there's high risk and no return. Investment is all about return on your money. It's as simple as that. The development will come. We're talking about developments, it's a wide range word, it can go anywhere. Development of government bodies, development of infrastructure, which if you walk to, every time I come to Egypt 2 months later, it's changed. Yes. There's so much infrastructure.
Yes, yes. So Mr. Sidaris, you are owner of Stores in Australia.
Yes.
So how can Egypt also help youth here to or support them of this kind of business?
I think there needs to be a mindset difference in approach when we're talking about youth.
Yes.
The children and the kids and the youth, if they don't see a future within the workplace, then they're not going to be put to work. They've got to see that there's something for them. All the
yes.
hard work, 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, and just to be an employer, it doesn't work. That's not how I run my business. I run my business, I have approximately 1,500 employees that work for me. I presume they're my family. That's how I treat them. They go on holidays, not all of them, of course, but certain awards are given to them, bonuses, so I treat them nicely, because there's something. Every single person needs to know that they are valuable in the bigger picture. If they're just an, if we talk about them just being an employee, then I wouldn't be successful
yes.
today. Now, there has to be a mind change in Egypt about when we're talking about creating businesses, that people need to know their worth. They need to know that they're going to put in all this effort, hard work, and they're going to get something more than just
yes.
a pay at the end of it.
Yes.
So each of my employees have what they call IDPs, Independent Development Programs. So every single person knows what their future is, what they do, how much work they do, what they'll get, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So
yes.
I think we just need to change our attitude around giving a little bit more to the
yes.
youth, to give them incentive to stay within the workplace.
Yes. So Mr. Sidaris, now since President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi came to office, he established mega projects like the new Suez Canal, the Alamin City, Bin Ban, station, and lots of Galala mountain project, and lots of mega projects.
Mm.
So you as an Egyptian living abroad or an expatriate, what does this reflect?
It reflects that there is a plan, that there is a vision, that the president has with all his ministers, has starting to execute that plan. There is a lot more that needs to be done, of course, but it, from the outside looking in, it's very exciting to see all this construction, all this work. If we can somehow create more jobs with this conference, because that would be the best outcome, that's good for everybody, because once people are working and earning money and spending money, then the whole wheel keeps turning. I think from the outside, in answer to your question, very excited by what's going on, excited to be here, want to be part of it. Not all of us know how to be part of it, so that's why we attend the conference and listen to what's being said.
Yes. So the conference this year is focusing on the migrant Egyptian women in investment.
Yes.
So how do you evaluate this role in your Egyptian community, in the Egyptian community in Australia?
Yeah, it's very difficult to be able to answer that question because it's not a traditional male-female. If people invest, everybody invests. But I think the roles that women play as CEOs and business leaders and CEOs of bigger companies are very hard to be able to establish as to how that reflects to Australia, because it's just different
world,
different laws, different ways.
Yes. So, Mr. Sidorus, how do you evaluate the previous conferences of EgyptCan that was titled EgyptCan for Education, EgyptCan for Women, and EgyptCan for Science and others?
I don't know too much about the other conferences. This is my first conference because it's business-related investment, and that's my area of expertise. But from what I've gathered so far, again, this is just part of the bigger vision, the bigger goal, the bigger objectives of what we want to achieve in Egypt as time goes on, and this is the next phase in it. But from what I've heard, they've been very successful.
Yes. How do you see the importance of this conference in building a contact between Egyptian expatriates and their homeland?
This is absolutely critical, this conference, because it has brought together, I think, 50 or 60 Egyptian-born or Egyptian second-generation business owners, doctors, all in the same conference, like I said earlier, with government leaders, with private sector. It's going to be so exciting to hear all of us talk together and see what the future is moving forward and how we can help make Egypt the way we'd all love to see it one day.
Yes. So we previously heard the President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi saying that the future of investment in the world is in Africa.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you evaluate this comment?
That's an interesting comment. It's the first time I've heard that quote.
No, he said it before.
He has. Okay, it's the first time I've heard it.
Yes.
It's big.
Africa is full of investment, of course.
Yes, it's big. I think just from what I've seen in Egypt alone, just this year, there is a mountain of opportunities with investment and building businesses within Egypt alone. Egypt is one small part of Africa, so I presume that quote would have to be very accurate. Very, very excited to see what I've seen in Egypt, and if it continues throughout Africa, then fantastic.
Yes, yes. So what do you expect about the recommendations or the outcome of this conference? You are just a participant, you are not a speaker.
I am speaking, yes. I am
you
speaking.
You are a speaker.
Yes, I am speaking.
So
yeah.
What are you planning to?
I'm going to be speaking about investments opportunities within Egypt and also the role of tourism. So I'm not...
That's a very important...
It is very important.
Point, of course. Would you like to shed the light on it?
I think tourism is your big win in Egypt.
Yes.
Our big win, I should say. I think if we get tourism right and we get it across the board, we have so much to show the world. And if we can do that, it will be a very, very big win for Egypt. The investment part, I'm still learning in that area. But like I said, every time I travel around, and I've seen a lot of opportunities, and excited to pursue them and see where it takes us.
Yes, yes. So, Mr. Sidorus, do you think that 2 days are enough to discuss everything in investment and development?
Never enough, two days, but to bring the amount of people that have come from around the world.
Yes.
In one place, and from my knowledge, I think there's 60 of us, not to mention participants. That's just, I think there's about 30 or 40 speakers in one place just for one day is fantastic. We've got them for two, perfect. We'd love to have it more, but it's a start. And we, from there, we'll stay in contact and we'll keep communicating.
Yes.
And I think the point that was made earlier was to continue the follow on so we don't lose the momentum.
Yes. So do you know any Egyptians also from Australia are coming and participating?
I have communicated with two people today, actually, that are coming. I don't know anything about them.
You don't know them before.
No,
when you were in Australia, that would be a good opportunity.
That's right.
That
so
you keep on contact when
exactly
you come back.
Right, yeah.
When you go back to Australia, of course.
Very exciting. And that's one of the things I think this kind of conference brings. It brings people from all around the world together. We talk. We then have each other's contacts. We can share ideas.
Yes. Yes. So is there anything would you like to add about your impression for attending this conference?
I can sum up by saying this is a very important conference for Egypt's future. It's the start, and I think we will be we'll hope to gain a lot out of the conference, and hope to continue with the follow through post the conference, and see where it takes us.
Yes. I thank you very much for your time, Mr. Hani Sideros, the owner of stores in Australia and a speaker and participant at the same time in the 5th Egypt Cannes Edition Conference for Investment and Development. Thank you very much for your time, sir.
My pleasure.
My pleasure. Well, with this, my dear viewers, we come to the end of this episode of our program, Cairo Local Time. I'm Amal Mukhtar. Thank you for watching.